Hello everyone, good evening to all of you. Today I am here in front of you with one more video, and this video is related to the numericals that are based on electrical braking. In the previous video, I will discuss with you all about the electrical braking, in which we are dealing. We have different types of electrical braking named as plugging, rheostatic or dynamic, as well as regenerative braking. In all these type of brakings, what we have to do, we are basically lower the speed of the motor, and this motor can be used in a locomotive to drive a vehicle, or this motor can be used in case of a drive system. So in order to control its speed, and in order to lower its speed to the normal value, or in order to stop the vehicle from its running condition to its stopping condition, we are generally employed a braking. Now, as I have already discussed in my previous videos, that the braking are generally of two types, that is the mechanical braking as well as electrical braking. But mechanical braking has certain disadvantages. So to overcome the disadvantages of that mechanical braking, we are employed the electrical braking. And moreover, this electrical braking is of different types, like plugging, rheostatic or dynamic, as well as regenerative braking. So first of all, what we have to do, we have to control its speed from its running condition to almost zero position. And when the vehicle or the motor, it tends to stop, at that time we are applying the mechanical braking. So by the combination of these two braking, your vehicle or your motor that can be used in a drive system is ultimately get stopped. So if you want to get more idea or the more information about this type of braking, where we can use this type of braking, what are the advantages, what are the disadvantages, and what are the various consequences in case of this braking, you can watch my previous video. But in this video, I will try to teach you some numericals based upon this electrical braking, how the numerical can be solved in case of an electrical braking. You can watch this video carefully, and after watching this video, if you have any problem related to solving this numerical, you can comment me in my comment box, or also you can message me. Your comments and your messages are always welcome. So I will try my best to teach you in a better option way. So not much taking your time, we'll start our numerical portion. So as you seen on your screens, there is one numerical, and this numerical is basically based upon your plugging numerical. Now what we have to do in this numerical, says a 220 volt 20 kW DC shunt motor running at its rated speed of 1200 rpm is to be braked by using plugging. The armature resistance is 0.1 ohm and rated efficiency of the motor is 88%. We have to calculate the three main things here. Number one, the resistance to be connected in a series in the armature to limit the initial braking current to the twice rated current, the initial braking torque, the torque when the speed of the motor falls to 400 rpm. Now what we have to do in this numerical, we are generally employ a plugging. And we know that in case of a plugging, what we have to do, we have to interconnect, change the connections of the armature winding as well as the field winding. And in order to limit the current, we are using an external resistance, and by keeping the changing the value of this external resistance, we can change its current. Now, what we have to do, you can see that your motor load current is given by your simply motor output upon voltage into efficiency. We know your motor output will be equals to 20 kW. So I can convert this 20 kW to 20 into 10 to the power 3. That will be 20 into 1000. upon the voltage will be given, that is 220, and efficiency will be given as 0.88, that is 88%. So here field current is equals to 103.3 amperes. Now I can use the full load torque formula, and in case of a motor torque, we have a formula, that is motor output upon 2 pi n upon 60. Now here again the motor output will be equals to 20 into 10 to the power 3, that is 20,000 upon 2 into 3.14 into n, that is speed 1200 upon 60. So here the value of the field current, that is the field torque, is equals to 159.15 newton meter. Now if we neglect the shunt field current, the reason being here the shunt field resistance we have not given. And we know that for calculating of the shunt field current, you are required the formula V upon RSH. And since RSH is not given, so I can neglect this formula. So here the armature current IA is equals to field current is equals to 103.3 ampere. Because in case of a shunt motor, your IA is equals to this value. So by the formula of back EMF or the induced EMF in case of a motor, the formula will be E is equals to V minus RA plus twice of VB if the brush drop voltage will be given. But now here the brush drop voltage is not given, so we can assume this VB is equals to zero. So there the value will be E is equals to V minus IA RA. Now I'm going to substitute the value 220 minus IA 103.3 into RA resistance is already given, that is 0.1. So here E is equals to 209.67. Now after that, the voltage across the armature at that time of braking is equals to your supply voltage, that is 220 volt, plus your generated or a back EMF voltage, that is 209.67. So if I add these two values, the value becomes as 429.67 volt. Is it clear to all of you? Now, what we have to do, as per the given condition, in your first condition, it is given that your braking current is equals to twice times the field current. So field current is equals to 103. So the braking current will be equals to twice into 103.3. So braking current will be equals to 206.66 amperes. Now we have to calculate the external resistance. So here the external resistance is equals to total voltage at braking. This total voltage at braking is equals to the voltage, terminal voltage plus your back EMF voltage upon you have IB, that is a braking current, minus external resistance. So when you substitute values, you can get a resistance is equals to 1.98 ohm. That means you have to insert a resistance of 1.98 in the case of a plugging so that your braking current is equals to twice of the field current. So this is your part number one. We have to calculate the external amount of or the value of the external resistance that must be inserted in case of a plugging. Now quickly coming to the second part, you have to calculate initial braking torque. The initial braking torque TB is given by TF into IB upon IF, where TF is the full load torque, IB is the braking current, and IF is the field current. So your full load torque is equal to 159.55 into braking torque, you know, twice of field current. So 206.6 upon field current, that is 103.3. So your initial braking torque will be 318.31 newtons meter. This is your second step. Now, after that, you have a third step, and in the third step, you have to calculate when the speed has fallen to 400 RPM, that means when the braking can be applied, your speed will be goes down from 1200 to 400. So at that time, what is your generated EMF? So here generated EMF is equals to your back EMF, that is older EMF, into N upon NF, where EB is equals to your previous EMF, N is your 400, NF is equals to 1200. So from that value, you can calculate the value of, that is 69.89 is the new EMF induced at the time of braking. Because EMF induced is directly proportional to the speed. If the speed will increase, the EMF is also increased, and vice versa. So here, the speed will decrease from 1200 to 400. there is a lot of variation in the speed. So at that case, your back EMF is also having a lot of changes. That is why this value here, the earlier case, if the value will become as 409 something, but now this value will be 69.8, and because the speed is get reduced from 1200 to 400 RPM. Now in this case, the braking armature braking current is the given by the formula, that is IB dash, that is a new braking current. In the older case, the braking current will be twice of IF. Now here we have new braking current, that is V plus EB dash upon R plus RA. So it will be 220 plus EB dash 69.89 upon 1.98. That is your resistance that must be inserted in the circuit in case of a plugging, plus armature resistance. So here the new braking current is equals to 139.37. So I think this will be clear to you. Now, after that, you have the only one step, that is a new electric braking torque. In this case, the formula will be TB is equals to TF into IB dash upon IF. So I can substitute this value. So here we get 2147.3 Newton meter. So I think this numerical will be clear to you. Quickly, I can say that your revision part, that we have to calculate the three main things. Number one, what is the value of the external resistance that will be must inserted in case of a plugging? Number two, the new braking current you have to calculate it. And thirdly, you have to calculate the braking torque. So by the means of that thing, we are all calculating this value. And one of the most important point that you must keep in mind, that while applying the braking, your speed will decrease from higher side to the lower side. So continuously at the same time, your back EMF is also get reduced. Earlier, the back EMF, I have already explained to you, it will be around 429 something, and later on the back EMF will be upon 69 point something. So as we are discussed in your theory part, that the speed is directly proportional to the back EMF. So here we can see it. So this is all about your first numerical. Now in case of a second numerical, you have given a 500 volt DC motor having an efficiency of 80%, operates a hoist having an efficiency of 70%. So here we have the two efficiencies. Number one will be the motor efficiency, and number two, it operates the hoist, and the hoist efficiency will be at 70%. Determine the current taken from the supply in order to raise the load of 500 kilogram at 4 meters per second. If the rheostatic braking is employed, what is the value of the external resistance that must be added in the armature circuit in order to lower the same load at a same speed? Now here again, we have to calculate the value of the external resistance, but only difference is that this is the numerical about rheostatic braking. This is not the numerical of the plug-in numerical. Is it clear? So we will start. First of all, the work done per second is equals to 500 into 9.81 into 4. This 500 will be mass, 9.81 is your gravity, and 4 is the speed. So the output will be 19620 newtons per meter square. We know that motor's input, that is simply output upon efficiency, and here is the output is equals to 19620 upon, we have two efficiencies, the motor efficiency as well as your hoist efficiency. Motor efficiency is 0.7. Hoist efficiency is 0.8. So therefore, the motor input will be equal to 35,035 watts. Now, simple formula, that is the current drawn from the supply is equals to input upon V. Input will be equals to 35,035 upon input voltage 500. So here the current drawn is equals to 70.7 amperes. I think up till that it is clear to you. Now, what we have to do, when the load is lowered, the machine will operate as a generator, because in that case we are applying the rheostatic braking, and we know in case of a rheostatic braking, the same machine, that is a motor, can be act as a generator, and the output of the generator will be dissipated in the resistance. Assuming the efficiency of the generator hoist and the generator is 70 to 80% respectively, so the same formula we can use and calculate power output of the generator, that is 500, 9.814 into 0.8, 0.7, the value will be 10987.2 watts. This is the same value which I can use in your motor case. Now, if the R is inserted in the circuit in order to rheostat braking, in order to limit the current, so there is a power dissipated, and the power dissipated given by the formula P is equals to V square upon R. So here, what I have to do, we have to convert this value, calculate the value of R. So here, the R is equals to V square upon P. So V is equals to 500, the whole square upon P, I have calculated. So here the R will be equals to 22.75. That means this amount of resistance you should must added in that rheostatic braking so that you can employ the braking and the vehicle get stopped. So I think both the numericals are clear to you. You can watch this video again. Try to solve this numerical at your places. And if you find any problem while solving the numerical, you can comment me or message me, as I have already told you. Your messages, your comments are always welcome. So I will try my best to get you people with some more numericals on this braking, because this braking is one of the most and most important concept, or you can say the topic in case of a drive as well as the utilization. So thank you so much for watching this video. Thank you so much. Stay home, stay safe. Thank you so much.